If Sauron can muster beasts alongside Uruks, his war machine will be unstoppable.
I do not have time for another one of your hunts, Master Dwarf.
Ah, but this is your hunt, Captain. There's a pack of war chiefs just arrived in Nurn. Call themselves Beastmasters.
That does sound like my kind of prey. What do I need to know?
I know you're familiar with the Khargars. I taught you everything you know about them. But let me tell you about their cousins from...
Torvin, what of the war chiefs? You didn't bring me here just to hunt another wild cat, did you?
Just to hunt another... Pay attention, Captain. These Khargars are a silent, stealthy breed from beyond Nurn. And they can sneak up on just about anything. And what's worse, this new beast tamer has been burning the brushlands to the north. He means to capture them and break their will, twist them into Sauron's war machine.
Every war chief is a scourge upon this land. Beastmaster or no, I will end them.
Whoa, slow down. First thing we need to do is foil their plans. And I see no better way of doing that than using the very same Khargars against this orcish scum.
Show me how to find one of these creatures, then.
Gladly, Captain. There's a Khargar hiding in those bushes. There it is. Go get it.
Ah, this beast does look useful.
Excellent. Now listen, there's an Uruk camp nearby. That's where they're bringing their captured beasts. I suggest you take your new pet and prowl up to them unnoticed.
Weapon out of the forge that'll cut the talk in two. Think of all the filth beyond the night. They got nothing to fear. When Mordor rises from shadow, fear is all they'll have.
Wait!
Said to get a bunch of slime. Kill his cargo! Next time.
Are in disarray, but there's still work to be done to ensure the Uruk never tame the Karagaths.
The war chief, the beast tamer.
Aye, that unnatural fiend needs to be put down. To draw him out, use the Karagaths against his war camp. The more Uruk that die by their shadowy bite, the better.
I will not let the Uruks exert mastery over these Karagaths. They are too dangerous.
As a lost ranger survived out here for
some. It's the keen edge what cuts the mountain, they say. But after days of hacking through Uruk heavy plate and Karagor hide, these blades aren't going to sharpen themselves. Our weapons are extensions of ourselves and demand respect. A well-honed blade sharpened with a genuine dwarven whetstone can make the difference between being a hunter or the prey. My brother Gorvin once took a swing at a Karagor, and his axe landed with a thud instead of a slide. He lived to tell the tale, and has been sharpening his blade every night since then.
There is little more satisfying than a sharp blade removing the head of an orc.
Mordor is in no short supply of terrible tales, and few more dreadful than the Black Captains of Sauron. I have never laid eyes on them myself, but their descriptions to me are the stuff of nightmares. A man trapped in perpetual agony in armor that does not grow with him. Another cursed for picking up the mace of Sauron after battle. And the mightiest among them, the Black Hand, is not spoken of in passing in these lands. May my beard grow ever longer ere I cross paths with these villains. I'll stick to hunting fair again.
The dwarf shied from the Black Captains as well he should. Only the Black Hand remains now, and I will finish him.
All right.
The solitary pass between the Valley of Udun to the north and the plateau of Gogoroth to the south is guarded by the dread, graven image of Sauron himself, with the great kinds of men held subjugated in chains. The rock and steel of this visage inspires no deference in me for the craftsmanship or stonework. And by my beard, I am thankful this is the closest I'll ever come to seeing the Dark Lord. The shadows grow long this evening. I will write no more.
I'd have liked to see Torvin's face when that statue came tumbling down and Sauron's head crashed to earth.
attention, Ranger!
I think your ride is here. Sending out extermination parties. They're wiping out every creature they can find. They're brutal killers, a lot of them.
An ambitious war chief with a well-trained army. Sounds like a challenge. But if you've taught me anything, Master Dwarf, it's that the Hunt can always turn against you.
I'm not entirely sure what's happening in that mind of yours, Captain. But you've baited the hook now. Come on, out with it!
I will bring a Grog to bear against their forces. I will show them Mordor cannot be tamed.
Now that's a plan! Not very military, though, is it? You've been spending a bit too much time with me. But there's one little problem you should know about.
Despite all expectations, your problems are rarely ever little, Torben.
Yes, well, and this shouldn't surprise you. These troops have already taken down a Grog. Or three? You'll need to lure out a rare, wretched Grog. A disgusting relative who's adapted to the poison from all the ghouls they eat.
Wretched Grog? Isn't that a bit redundant?
I'm not sure what redundant is, but if it means poisonous, then yes, they are extremely redundant.
All right, Master Dwarf. Show me how to lure these creatures out, and I will do the rest.
Just a few scouts tangling with those ghouls. They should make easy prey.
Put up your blades, murderers! Your savagery comes to an end this day!
This isn't all fair, Doug.
Witcher may have lost his ranging parties, but as long as he remains safe in his stronghold, he'll train more of those killers. Show him the safety he can expect with a wretched Graug at his doorstep.
Even the Uruks fear the monstrosities of Mordor. They must kill the butcher and keep the orcs afraid.
I've amassed a worthy collection of treasure and trophies, heads and hides from all manner of fell beast, and even some lovely trinkets from the Second Age. But the whispered tales of one artifact continue to elude me. The legendary Forge Hammer, used by the elves to craft the Rings of Power themselves. The hammers I've found so far in my hunt have brought me no closer to finding the one I seek. Perhaps the spirit of the elves do not want to see their precious artifact in the hands of a dwarf.
Torvin will never understand how closely this hammer is bound to our fate, and that of all Middle-earth.
Yeah.
Expect with a wretched growl at his doorstep. Show him the safety he can expect with a wretched growl at his doorstep.
Ah! creature will help you face me? There is no beast that I cannot kill. I will eviscerate you both.
Kill you easy, no problem.
So shall perish all enemies of Sauron. Stay dead. Now I will humiliate you a second time. I will give your corpse fire! Think of new!
This should put an end to the butcher's extermination parties. Let the Uruks suffer the ravages of nature.
spill a drop of his own blood in a fight.
Nah, Clark.
Ranger!
I'm in no mood for your troublemaking.
You will die quickly.
Just my luck.
Back you, maggot.
I've met a mysterious man in my travels, a ranger of Gondor, named Talion. Over our fire, I asked after his weapons, impressive in their craftsmanship. A handsome blade, Orphael, has been at his side since his days stationed at the Black Gate, defending the borders of Gondor. But his dagger, Achan, carries a sad tale. It too was once a mighty sword, carried by his murdered son, Broken. The night he died. Talion tells me Achan means vengeance, and I have a feeling the blade will fulfill the meaning of its name.
I have slain countless Uruk, but still I seek vengeance.
Thank you. from the side!
Slow moving, but nigh unstoppable. These great beasts appear to be distant cousins of the six-tusked Mumakil. Even a great hunter like myself has never brought down one of these beasts as a trophy. But they're not difficult to track. The very earth shakes under their thundering feet. It's wise to keep on your toes when you're around them so you don't end up underneath theirs. I've seen them rampage and crush orc, troll, and man alike into jelly.
I'm surprised Torben isn't trying to recruit me into hunting one of those mammoths.
A slave! Louis,
there's the ranger!
These war chiefs, they've caused so much death and destruction. Scavengers are running amok, just hordes upon hordes of filthy ghouls.
Filthy ghouls? I thought all of Mordor's creatures were majestic in their own way.
Majestic? Ghouls? Now you stop right there, Captain. They are an aberration. Those filthy little mongrels, hiding underground with their beady eyes, gnawing and biting and scratching and...
If I didn't know better, I'd have thought you'd see eye to eye with the little creatures.
Are you comparing me with a ghoul? Oh, I'm glad this plague of ankle biters makes you laugh. Their numbers are growing out of control. They'll overrun all of Nurn.
Well, you do have a point. So how can we curb this disease?
There's only one way. We need to drag their vile queens from their nests and cut them down. A ghoul hive without a matron is like a meal without ale. Useless!
Captain says he wants to see the land stripped bare. Says he only see greedy ones.
Scurrying about with the sun in the sky. Just terrible.
There was no matron.
Aye, not this time. Keep rustling their mounds, though. Matrons will come, I promise you.
If the ride is stupid enough to get close to me, I'll pick up and toss him to the ground so hard his back will break.
In ghoul filth. I see now why Torvin kept his distance.
Good news, Talion. You still haven't matched me for ghouls killed in a single afternoon.
For once, it is I who has come up short.
I'll give you that one, Ranger. But killing this next war chief is going to be a tall order. You see, he rides upon a Graug. You'll have to flood his garrison with ghouls to set our enemies against each other.
Ghouls were ever to become more organized, all of Nurn would be infested in short order.
If it's worthy game and a respectable trophy you're after, the Caragol roam Mordor in ferocious packs. Quick on their feet and strong to boot, be wary. Their claws are sharper than steel, and I've seen them crush rock-hard orc skulls like eggs in their jaws. Even wargs and lions give them wide berth. One look at these beasts, and you'll know why the pointy ears have named them Bringers of Fear.
First the Caragors, now the Karagaths. How many ways has Mordor to kill a man?
You'd think the sight of a lone peak in the countryside would bring cheer to a dwarf's heart. But alas, that is not so here. Orodruin, the Mountain of Fire. This volcano stands alone on the plateau of Gorgoroth, but the whole of Mordor seems to dwell in its shadow.
It's said Sauron chose this land for his domain because of that mountain. And I hope it suits him. Even dormant, anyone unlucky enough to travel these lands has that hill to thank for choking this acrid air, filling our lungs with ash and our hearts with dread.
How long before it erupts once more and spreads its darkness over Mordor?
The archers are running drills today.
Of Mordor, their greatest are the fighting Uruk-hai. And among them, their vicious captains reign over the tribes and armies with ironclad fists. I've dodged more than one pack of foul Uruk on my hunt to these dire lands, and I've stolen glimpses of the rite of ascension among these foul folk. Only the strongest and most devious lead, slaughtering their own kind until none stand to oppose them. Brutal, savage, dangerous, and they don't smell very sweet either.
No doom keeps this dwarf from the grave. His first death will be his last, and his courage is impressive.
Against his war cowl. The more Uruk that die by their shadowy bite, the better.
So what? We'll make a meal before our lord's might.
Did I just hear something?
Thank you.
Beast Tamer is dead, and with him, the Uruk's control of the shadowy creatures.
I'm not going to
if you can, Captain. We've no time to lose.
Fought Torven, but could you spare a moment to explain what this is all about?
We've got a big problem, Talion. A very big problem.
I've never known you to think anything was little, Master Dwarf.
Now is not the time for jokes, Rachel. My camp was ransacked. Pilfering Uruks made off with all my blasting powder and my brother's axe.
The Uruks have your explosive powder? How did this happen?
Forget about that. Didn't you hear what I said? They took my brother's axe!
We'll get your axe, but I'm more concerned about the Uruks with the explosives. Do you even know how the powder works?
All I know is that if you put a spark to it, exciting things happen. Surely you remember when we first met?
These war chiefs may study it, learn how to make more. We must get it back before that can happen.
Tracks split up here. You follow them to the north. I'll hunt the bastards to the south. Find them quickly, Ranger, before they can hide their new treasures.
There's no time to spare. I must ride this scum down as fast as I can.
To the north, I'll hunt the bastards to the south. Find them quickly, Ranger, before they can hide their new treasures.
No time to spare. I must ride this scum down as fast as I can.
Up here. You follow them to the north. I'll hunt the bastards to the south. Find them quickly, Ranger, before they can hide their new treasures.
There's no time to spare. I must ride this scum down as fast as I can.
some cowardly maggots are worried about
the what was that?
Did he stand up?
Blasting powder or Torvin's axe. The thieves must have moved that bounty elsewhere.
I need to make haste. These thieves must be stopped at all costs.
Ranger, I found the damned Uruk running off with my brother's axe.
A small victory. There's no trace of the blasting powder anywhere.
Something that valuable, only the smuggler could deliver it to his dark master. It's better blown up and wasted than in their hands. You'll have to track down his couriers and destroy them along with their cargo.
Or if we killed by their own kind.
Then must find and kill the smuggler and his... The blasting powder cannot fall into Sauron's hands.
Yeah.
Few things in Mordor cause even the Uruks and trolls to quake in fear. And one such beast is the rare horned Graug. Standing nearly 5 dwarves tall, they're nigh unstoppable juggernauts of wanton destruction. Their very skin is tougher than leather, resistant to even the sharpest steel, if you can get close enough to strike a blow. But I wouldn't give for a mithril blade on my next hunt for these dire monstrosities.
Saw the talk, Roddy. I'm a cow. Thank you.
I wonder what the dwarf is obsessed over now that his hated Graug is slain.
His garrison with ghouls to set our enemies against each other.
Hello.
Watch out for these little buggers, Ranger. They bite! Before my master, Worm! You'll find it's not so unpleasant when you get used to it.
Cheer me now!
Ugh.
I'll do you first!
Oh!
My master leaves your corpse for me to play with! Before my master, Worm, you'll find it's not so unpleasant when you get used to it.
Point!
did that Uruk manage to tame a Grog? I hope I have put a permanent end to such an alliance.
Suffer me now!
Stop moving! Raise that beacon!
To track down his couriers and destroy them along with their cargo.
Deliver the blasting powder. They will wreak unknown havoc. Blasting powder could even make short work of the walls of Minas Ethel.
deliver to the Dark Lord, and now I'll deliver your head. That is a promise, you schmuck. There's nothing left between you and me. Good. Come you up and deliver your pieces to the corners of Mordor. Meet Mordor.
None of that talk.
Remember, fool.
Come on.
You won't trick me. The rule of men shall extinguish itself in a mighty blaze.
The smuggler is dead and the blasting powder destroyed. Who knows what catastrophes I've averted this day.
The sweet pain in your flesh when I bite into your corpse. I know the steps to that dance. You're wasting my time. You're too weak.
Every time there's a geyser, another 1,000 ghouls come up out of the ground.
Someone's sneaking about.
Oh, it's just the worst. That's the worst. Unnatural. Filthy. Disgusting.
Slow down, dwarf. What are you ranting about this time?
The last of these new war chiefs. He's a ghoul keeper. Somehow he's controlling the little bastards. Worse, actually, I think he's friends with them.
Controlling them? An Uruk commanding a ghoul army?
Aye, it's so, so dirty.
What can be done? The ghouls are endless. We can't kill them all.
No, but... shudder to say it. Hate to even think it, but maybe...
Come on, out with it then.
Well, it's just that your power... You seem to be able to control everything. Uruks, Karagors, Graugs. Could you control the little scavengers too?
You would have me control the ghouls as well? Isn't that a bit hypocritical?
Well, if by hypocritical you mean brilliant, then yes, it's very hypocritical. Look, I know it's disgusting, but it's for a good cause. Now, go control those redundant ghouls.
Start, I suppose. Let's keep going.
Oh, I can see them brushing up against you. I can feel them from here. This was a horrible idea.
Should be more of them. Something's not right.
Just keep knocking on their doors until they answer, Captain. Let's move!
Come on.
That's the worst. That's the worst! Unnatural. Filthy. Disgusting.
Slow down, dwarf. What are you ranting about this time?
The last of these new war chiefs. He's a ghoul keeper. Somehow he's controlling the little bastards. Worse, actually, I think he's friends with them.
Controlling them? An Uruk commanding a ghoul army?
Aye, it's so, so dirty.
What can be done? The ghouls are endless. We can't kill them all.
No, but, shudder to say it. Hate to even think it, but, maybe...
Come on, out with it, then.
Well, it's just that your power... You seem to be able to control everything. Uruks, Karagors, Graugs. Could you control the little scavengers, too?
You would have me control the ghouls as well? Isn't that a bit hypocritical?
What?
To start, I suppose. Let's keep going.
Oh, I can see them brushing up against you. I can feel them from here. This was a horrible idea. Impressive. Disgusting, but impressive. I think we're ready to end this hunt. The ghoul keeper hides in an infested cave. Stalk in, steal away his pets, and kill him.
I don't know why I didn't consider dominating these creatures sooner.
Practically unbeatable once he's riding around a wall.
steal away his pets, and kill him.
But I'm not coming in! A dwarf unwilling to go underground! You see what these ghouls have done to me?
What's going on out there? Are you all coming on my lace?
Lovelies. That is more affectionate than I had anticipated.
Ghouls! My pets! My babies! You cannot take them! You shall not! Babies are better off dead than in your thrall. We will avenge this version of our family.
Hurry! He's out here! If you're still alive!
To see
Isn't stealing away my lovelies enough for you? Oh, I'll tear you apart for what you've done!
This threat is over, Torvan. All these foul Beastmaster war chiefs have met their end.
We accomplished great things together, Captain.
We certainly have our moments, Dwarf. You even managed to do all right around those ghouls.
You know, Captain, I think I may have been too harsh on the little fiends. Those scampering monsters might not be so terrible after all. They can have their uses, at least.
Will you look at that? You can grow a little. Even if it's only emotionally.
Ooh, not your best, Talion. Well, I should be on my way. Blue Mountains are waiting.
Safe journeys, my friend.
Take blow after blow and still have fighting. Something just moved!